Hey everyone, Mr. Happy here, and in this video, I want to give you my thoughts on my first impressions on the Dissidia Final Fantasy NT closed beta. Now, there were some netcode issues, there was some matchmaking issues with some lag, but in the 7 hours that I played it, I managed to get from Bronze E, which there's 5 ranks going up to A, all the way to Silver A. So I basically increased my rank by 10, although the first 5 ranks are kind of easy because you can't really D-rank once you get to that point. But anyway, I want to give you my first thoughts, my impressions on the game on the PS4, things that it currently is not doing and things that it currently is doing very well. So just as a basic overview, let me explain the basics of Dissidia just so you can follow along. Now, if you played the old PSP games, you should be mostly familiar with the things I'm about to tell you, but let's just go over a few things. For one, the current roster that's playable in the beta is just the main heroes from Final Fantasies 1 through 14. That's the Warrior of Light, Firion, Onion Knight, Cecil, Bartz, Terra, Cloud, Squall, Zidane, Tidus, Shantotto, Vaughn, Lightning, and Yshtola. Now keep in mind there are more characters available than that in the arcade version, and those will be available when the game launches, as well as Noctis Lucis Calum, who was confirmed to be a launch character for the PS4 release of the game, so expect a wider array of characters, including the villains from each of those games, or at least from most of those games, when we get closer to launch itself. As for the functions in the closed beta, there's just the most basic ones: online matches against other real opponents, AI matches just for practice, and a tutorial. Now, the matches themselves are 3 players versus 3 players, though early in the morning when there weren't as many people on, I did have some AI filling in if my queues got too long, but there were some matchmaking issues anyway, so it was hard to tell when it was really filling in the AI. So your goal in every individual battle: first, you want to raise your bravery account by using your X attacks. Then, when you think you can hit an enemy with a special attack, you use your circle attacks on the PlayStation 4 controller to expend that bravery and deal damage to the enemy's health, which everyone seems to have 3,500 flat health. To do this, you're also given a loadout with specific HP attacks and some secondary special attacks that can buff allies or debuff opponents. In the beta, you can't customize this, but it has been confirmed that when the full game comes out, you'll be able to customize this loadout yourself. So when one team has accrued 3 incapacitations, basically lowering any of the 3 opponents' health to 0, the match ends. You could KO the same person 3 times, you can knock out each enemy once, you can knock out one person twice, another person once. Doesn't matter. As soon as you've incapacitated the enemy team 3 times, you are declared the winner. Or if you're incapacitated 3 times, you're declared the loser. If the time runs out, the game makes the team with the higher point total the winner. Points are gained through supporting teammates, outplaying opponents, basically playing well. Throughout the games, you also gain summoning points by attacking summon crystals. When you have a full bar, your team can bring forth a classic Final Fantasy summon, 1 of 7, I believe, which not only grants buffs before summoning, but also makes life uneasy for your opponents. So that's the bare basics of Dissidia. Now, I played quite a bit of it today, and my first impressions were overall pretty good. I didn't really have high expectations for it. I've been waiting a very long time for Dissidia to hit the PlayStation 4 because I was a big fan of the games back on the PSP. But I've just had kind of tempered expectations with things like this recently with Square Enix, just because I haven't played them myself, so it's hard to be excited about something I haven't really gotten my hands on. And there were a lot of things that I felt like the Dissidia beta did well. It felt like I had a good arsenal of attacks. I played today entirely as Shantotto. I literally only played Shantotto, but I got to see a lot of the different play styles with pretty much all the different characters that I played against and that were on my team. And it feels like there's a lot of balanced matchups. It feels like even if you're a character with a lot of power, you're usually open or are more vulnerable. Some characters have to play more aggressive, which if you make a mistake means you're going to be punished way harder. And it felt like there was a good balance of all the different play styles. Depending on which character you pick, there are 4 different classes that they're kind of just placed into. Some are considered vanguards, which are like frontliners that are not tanky. Tanky's not the right word, but they're not super fast. You know, they have a very specific playstyle. Marksmans, who are usually slow and vulnerable and need help with from their team, but can very easily devastate opponents if left untouched. You have assassins who are very fast and are able to get in and get out with quick combos and get around the map very quickly. A lot of them tend to have lunge attacks in their kits as well. And then you have specialists, which I believe are mostly focused on a combination of team support as well as some offense. Generally, specialist offense, I'm not really sure how it plays in, because I don't know, because a lot of the times I was going up against a specialist and I couldn't really tell there was a huge difference in their playstyle versus the way they everyone else was playing. But it might just be because in these lower ranks, everyone is kind of trying to play the game the same, because a lot of people are learning it for the first time and they don't really understand the way the different mechanics work and things like wake-up attacks and proper dodging and proper blocking. And there's so many different things to keep track of that it can sometimes get really confusing. I mean, look at the user interface. This is something that I don't think I can do this video without commenting on. The user interface is pretty busy. I mean, you have your team's stats in the bottom left. You have your opponent's team stats in the bottom right. You have your own personal, you have the incapacitation bar in the top left. You have both team summon bars in the top left with that. You have the timer for the game. And then at the top right, you have the break bonus. And then you have the mini map. So there's a lot of things to keep track of. On top of that, they use the Final Fantasy 12-esque arrows to let you know when someone's targeting you or to let an opponent know that you're targeting them. It's just, it's very, very busy. And they said they are going to work on reducing it down from the arcade version, or to have a more compact version of it, one that's a little bit less busy. And that's something I think that they could definitely do with, because a lot of people just, it's just a ton of information to be tracking at any given time. After an hour or two of doing it, the only thing I ever really looked at was enemy HP values and the minimap, because I could keep track of the incapacitates myself. I could keep track of the summoning just by paying attention to us attacking the crystals. You know, just, it felt like there was a lot of information I wasn't using on the screen, and I didn't feel like it was particularly debilitating to not make use of it. So there's definitely a little too much information on the screen, it feels like at times. Other than that, I said it earlier, it felt mostly balanced. Considering I was playing a marksman, I felt like I had some control over getting away, but it felt like if I got ganged up on by three people, I had very few options, which, to be fair, is something that I think most of the players would have a hard time with. But I have seen some pretty impressive Tidus's and Clouds just outplaying entire teams. And even as Shantotto, with some pretty strong AoE skills and some pretty fast projectiles and high priority projectiles, I found myself able to protect myself okay. There was really only a handful of abilities that helped me a ton, but it was better than having nothing at all. If anything, the hardest part about being targeted by three people, especially if there's also a summon which gives you a fourth potential target, is the camera. For the most part, the camera just basically depends on who you're targeting. It'll kind of point you in their direction. So when you're being targeted by two, three people, you then need to look at the minimap, but you're trying to pay attention to the person that you're attacking to make sure that that you can, you know, utilize or make use of whatever whatever attacks they're using to try and fit in attacks of your own. So it can just get very, very overwhelming if an enemy team decides to gang up on you. I don't really know that there's much room for improvement there. I mean, you can use the right stick to adjust the camera, but it always felt like I was fighting the camera, especially in some of the maps. Of the 12 maps there are, I think there were maybe three of them where it never felt like I could get my camera in the right place to kind of keep track of everything properly. So I'm not really sure what they can do to adjust that. It's just the natural result of it being 3v3 with this open field and people being able to change targets and stuff like that. But overall, I had a lot of fun with what I played today, and I am looking forward to the launch itself. The big thing for me is I want to get my hands on the characters that are in the arcade and weren't available here, because Shantotto was a lot of fun. I think the marksman playstyle is something that suits me, meaning characters like Terra or Kefka might be more up my alley than someone like a Cloud or a Zidane, who, by the way, was a pain in the ass today. But I can't really tell entirely yet. One of the things I do like is, even though I said I progressed Shantotto to Silver A, which is basically the 10th total rank in the game, what happens is all your characters share a rank up until you get to Silver. Once you get to Silver, all your characters are at Bronze A. And so if you want to increase their rank, your ELO or your matchmaking rank is solely based on the experience you have with an individual character. That leaves a lot of room open for people to either just choose the main one and get really good on it, or for people to kind of go for that completionist goal of getting the highest rank on every individual character. It's almost like mastery points in a sense, because even if you get up to Diamond A on one character, you can have another character at Bronze A and you could do that grind all over again. And considering there's over 20 characters in the main roster, there's a lot of time spent that you could actually spend learning all the individual characters and their specialties. One of the big things was trying to learn the right properties for everything, like what had projectile priority, you know, what had a super armor. Super armor basically meaning that it goes through attacks, something Cloud I learned had in spades. There was also learning things like, you know, the right times to use my special attacks. Do I want to use them offensively? Do I want to use them since they make me invincible as a marksman? Do I want to use them defensively? Can I group people up with them? Can I save a teammate by enfeebling them so they have no dash power? There's a lot of little strategic elements, but the gameplay itself is very simple, you know. With Shantotto, I have things like wake-up attacks. You know, if somebody's on the ground and I lay down a stone under them and I time it right, right as they get up, I'll be able to pop them out of their grounded state. So I like all the little elements. I think it could still use with some fine-tuning, but I think that they've got a very solid experience on their hands. It's really going to come down to how this launch eventually goes in early 2018, and I hope they continue to do betas because there's just been so much lag and so many matchmaking issues that I hope they want to run more tests to make sure it's working okay. If you didn't get to play the Dissidia closed beta, I am planning on doing a couple of videos on it. Unfortunately, I'm going to be at PAX West starting next Thursday, which means I don't have a whole lot of time to produce content on Dissidia itself because half of the closed beta days I'll be in Seattle. So I'll do what I can. You know, maybe a Shantotto overview if I get time on another character, I'll do that as well. But I got a lot on my hands right now, so I'll do what I can for you guys. Anyway, let me know what you thought if you've had the chance to play this either on the PS4 or in the arcades over in Japan. Be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share, and stay tuned, because I'll do what I can to produce some more Dissidia videos, and hopefully they do other betas so I have more time to do so. Anyway, thanks for watching, and until next time, take care.